Hey folks, I'm Scott Siegel, and welcome to the third edition of my Great American Songbook Concert Series, starring some of New York's most talented musical theater, nightclub, and concert stars. Given the state of our world right now, there are a lot of obstacles to performing, not the least of which is that theater, nightclub, and concert performers are all out of work. But for this concert, everybody gets paid. Yes, actual money. I set up a GoFundMe campaign in order to raise money to pay performers to sing. And thanks to more than 90 generous lovers of live entertainment who contributed amounts large and small, I've been able to create now three different concerts, including this one, that those 90 wonderful people have produced. You'll see all their names at the end of the concert. They are the producers of our show. Now, if you want to keep the series alive, please consider becoming a producer yourself, and I hope you will. All you have to do is go to GoFundMe.com and search for Let's Pay Performers to Perform. Click on that and donate. Any amount you feel comfortable with will be hugely appreciated. Hopefully, you'll see that information on your screen periodically throughout our show, but only when I'm talking, never during a performance. I should add, however, that several of tonight's performers, in an act of generosity of their own, have decided to give their payments back so that other performers in future concerts who may need it more can get paid, and we thank them for that. And now on with the show. And we'll start with this great American songbook standard, I Got Rhythm. It might surprise you to learn that this famously driving, up-tempo smash hit song started out as a slow ballad for the Gershwin Brothers' 1928 musical Treasure Girl. That is, before they cut it, and then gave it to Ethel Merman 2 years later to belt out in Girl Crazy. The lyric for I Got Rhythm did not come easily. As songwriters often do, Ira Gershwin filled in nonsense rhyming words they call dummy lyrics, as placeholders to keep Brother George's melody in his head and get a sense of the structure. Their temporary words, not ever meant to be known by you, went like this, to the rhythm of I Got Rhythm. Roly-poly, eating solely, ravioli, better watch your diet or bust. Lunch or dinner, you're a sinner, please get thinner, losing all that fat is a must. So, happily, I didn't sing it in Girl Crazy. When it was finally finished with the actual lyrics, George Gershwin said it was his favorite among all of his creations. And here's one of my favorites, a gentleman who is a quadruple threat as an actor, singer, dancer, and choreographer. He starred on Broadway in Dames at Sea and starred on just about the biggest stage in New York City when he headlined the 2017 Radio City Music Hall Summer Spectacular. Here is Danny Gardner. Thank you. song you're going to hear next was first introduced in the film New York, New York that was directed by Martin Scorsese. The song was written by Kandra Neb for the film's female star, Liza Minnelli. And this song that Liza sang in the film became the title of a critically acclaimed and long-running off-Broadway musical review of Kandra Neb's songs. This is that title song. And to sing it for you, I have the great pleasure of introducing the star of that off-Broadway musical who first performed it on stage and made it her own. She's also starred on Broadway a bunch of times, most notably as one of the stars of the original Broadway cast of Mamma Mia. Here is one of New York's most beloved performers, Karen Mason.
Sometimes you're happy, and sometimes you're sad, but the world goes round. Sometimes you lose every nickel you had, but the world goes round. Sometimes your dreams get broken in pieces, but that doesn't alter a thing. Take it from me, there's still gonna be a summer, a winter, a fall, and a spring. And sometimes your friends start treating you bad, but the world goes around. And sometimes your heart breaks with a deafening sound. Somebody loses, somebody wins. One day it kicks, then it kicks in the shins. But the planet spins and the world goes around. The world goes round. The world goes round. Sometimes your dreams get broken in pieces, but that doesn't matter at all. Take it from me, there's still gonna be a summer, a winter, a spring, and a fall. And sometimes your friends start treating you bad, but the world goes around. And sometimes your heart breaks with a deafening sound. Somebody loses, somebody wins. One day it kicks, then it kicks in the shins. But the planet spins and the world goes round and round and around and around and around. The world goes round and round and round.
In December of 1933, an all-black review opened on Broadway with the optimistic title The Blackbirds of 1934. It closed 3 weeks later, never quite making it to 1934, but there was a song in that score that has lasted 87 years so far, and I guarantee it will still be around 100 years from today. To perform it for you, I'm delighted to present a gentleman who has starred in 10 Broadway shows and is one of America's leading concert artists who performs with symphonies all over the world. With accompaniment by world-class guitarist Sean Harkness, here is Sal Viviano. ¶¶
kisses, just pass them around. You'll find my reason is logically sound. Who's gonna know that you pass them around 100 years from today? Why crave a penthouse that's fit for a queen? You're nearer heaven on Mother Earth's green. If you had millions, what would they all mean 100 years from today? So laugh and sing, make love the thing, be happy while you may. There's always one beneath the sun who's bound to make you feel that way. The moon is shining, that's a good sign. Cling to me closer, swear you'll be mine. Remember, darling, we won't see shine 100 years from today. Sing, make love your thing, be happy while you may. There's always one beneath the sun who's bound to make you feel that way. The moon is shining, that's a good sign. Cling to me closer, swear you'll be mine. Remember, darling, we won't see it shine 100 years from today.
'Child.' It only dates back to 1950. It's titled Orange Colored Sky, and Nat King Cole had the first hit recording of it that same year, backed by the Stan Kenton Orchestra. In homage to her father, Natalie Cole recorded it many years later. Now, a unique aspect of the song is that it was featured on a TV show in 1950. Orange Colored Sky is considered to be one of the first songs to become a hit because of its exposure on television. Through the years, the song has been performed by the likes of Danny Kaye, Doris Day, Screamin' Jay Hawkins, and actually both Burt Ward, who played Robin in the Batman TV show, and Batman himself, Adam West, who actually performed the song live in his Batman costume on the 1966 episode of Hollywood Palace. To sing it for you now, it's my pleasure to introduce you to a young woman who has starred in and been critically acclaimed in two different editions of Forbidden Broadway, as well as Spamilton, and of course on Broadway in Rocky the Musical. Here is Jenny Lee Stern.
I was walking alone, minding my business, when out of an orange-colored sky, crash, bam, alakazam, wonderful you came by. I was humming a tune, drinking in sunshine, when out of an orange-colored view, crash, bam, alakazam, I gotta look at you. One look and I yell, timber, watch out for flying glass. Then the ceiling fell in and the bottom went out. I went into a spin and I started to shout, I've been hit, this is it, this is it. I was walking alone, minding my business, when love came and hit me in the eye. Crash, bam, alakazam, out of an orange-colored sky. One look and I yell, timber, watch out for flying glass. Then the ceiling fell in and the bottom went out. I went into a spin and I started to shout, I've been hit, this is it, this is it. I was walking alone, minding my business, when love came and hit me in the eye. Crash, bam, alakazam, out of an orange color, purple striped, green and blue polka dot sky. Crash, bam, alakazam, and goodbye.
Now, here's a song from William Finn's much-admired off-Broadway hit, A New Brain, that somehow never transferred to Broadway. Nonetheless, this song from the show has sailed on a wave of star performances to become a contemporary Great American Songbook standard that is now regularly performed in nightclubs and in concert halls. To sing I'd Rather Be Sailing, it gives me great pleasure to introduce you to a bright young talent who just last summer made his town hall debut in Broadway's Rising Stars, and since then he has performed several times at Feinstein's 54 Below. Please welcome Christopher Bryan.
Sailing, yes, I would, on an open sea. I'd stand at the railing if I could, feeling wild and free. The sun is on my neck, the wind is in my face, the water's incredibly blue, and I'd rather be sailing. Yes, I wanna go sail and then come home to you. Sex is good, but I'd rather be sailing. Food is nice, but I'd rather be sailing. People are swell, but I'd rather be sailing. Over the horizon. And I'd rather be sailing. Yes, I would. I'd stand there inhaling if I could, feeling wild and free. The sun is on my neck, the wind is in my face, the sea is incredibly blue, and I'd rather yes, I wanna go sail, and then come home to you. I'd rather be sailing, yes, I wanna go sail, and then come home to you.
Now, it'll come as no surprise to you that a lot of Frank Sinatra's hit songs are part of the Great American Songbook. And in the mid to late 1960s, Sinatra had a great resurgence with a string of hit recordings in what was otherwise the rock and roll top 40 era. One of those songs was this tune that quickly became yet another one of his signature songs. He recorded it in 1966. And one of the reasons this song was a hit was due to the producer insisting on another take when Sinatra was already satisfied and was ready to leave. Frank was really irritated, and that irritation gave the producer the quality that he wanted in Sinatra's recording. The song is That's Life. And to sing it for you, here's a gentleman who starred on Broadway in the first revival of Into the Woods as the Baker. But he's probably best known for his recurring role as Eddie Cantor in the TV series Boardwalk Empire. Here is Steven DeRosa.
Let's get our Frank on, shall we? Grab a cocktail and don't forget to sing along. I need you. That's life. That's what all the people say. You're riding high in April, shut down in May. But I know I'm gonna change that tune when I'm back on top in June. I said that's life, and as funny as it may seem, some people get their kicks stomping on a dream. But I don't let it get me down. 'Cause this wide old world, it keeps spinning around. I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I've been up and down and over and out. And I know one thing, each time I find myself flat on my face, I pick myself up and get back in the race. That's life. That's life, and I can't deny it. Many times I thought of quitting, baby, but my heart just ain't gonna buy it. And if I didn't think it was worth one single try, I'd jump right on a big bird and then I'd fly. I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I've been up and down and over and out. And I know one thing, each time I find myself flat on my face, I pick myself up and get back in the race. That's life. That's life. And I can't deny it. Many times I thought of quitting, baby, but my heart just ain't gonna buy it. But if there's nothing shaking come this here July, I'm gonna roll myself up in a big ball and die. Stay safe, baby.
Okay, I'm back to the regular hat. Sinatra's over. I can wear this now. All right. So most Broadway shows that flop disappear without a trace. Some of the lucky ones become notable footnotes in Broadway history because one great song escaped from the debris to become a hit. Well, Stephen Sondheim had a catastrophic flop early in his career with the Broadway collapse of his show Anyone Can Whistle. It opened on Broadway in 1964 and had 12 previews and all of 9 performances before it closed. You might think the show's most notable footnote might be that this was the show in which Angela Lansbury made her Broadway debut. But there is so much more that came out of that flop. The score produced at least four songs that have become Great American Songbook standards. The title tune, Anyone Can Whistle, Everybody Says Don't, There Won't Be Trumpets, and this fourth beautiful ballad, which you're about to hear titled With So Little to Be Sure Of. To sing it for you, I'm happy to introduce you to a woman who is an award-winning nightclub vocalist with a heavenly voice that suits her day job, which will become readily apparent when you see her perform. Here is Josephine Sanges.
With so little to be sure of, if there's anything at all, if there's anything at all, I'm sure of here and now and us together. All I'll ever be, I owe you. If there's anything to be, being sure enough of you makes me sure enough of me. Thanks for everything we did, everything that's past, everything that's over too fast. None of it was wasted, all of it will last. Everything that's here and now and us together. It was marvelous to know you, and it isn't really through. Crazy business, this life we live in. Don't complain about the time we're given. With so little to be sure of in this world, we had a moment, a marvelous moment, a marvelous moment.
Now our next song, titled This Is Me, became a hit as recently as 2017 when it was performed by a friend of mine, Keala Settle, in the Hugh Jackman film The Greatest Showman. The song won the Golden Globe Award for Best Original Song at the 75th Golden Globe Awards and was nominated for an Academy Award for Best Original Song at the 90th Academy Awards, where Keala performed it live on TV. It was later nominated for a Grammy. To sing it for you now, I'm delighted to have another young friend of mine perform it for you. She's from Venezuela, having come to the United States to find her future on the American musical theater stage. Please welcome her. Here is Bettina Lobo.
I'm not a stranger to the dark. Hide away, they say, 'cause we don't want your broken parts. I've learned to be ashamed of all my scars. Run away, they say, no one will love you as you are. But I won't let them break me down to dust. I know that there's a place for us, for we are glorious. When the sharpest words wanna cut me down, oh, Another round of bullets hits my skin. We'll fire away, cause today I won't let the ship sink in. We are bursting through the barricades and reaching for the sun.
We are warriors.
Yeah, that's what we've become. Won't let them break me down to dust. I know that there's a place for us. For we are glorious. When the sharpest words wanna cut me down.
"You've Got a Friend" was written by Carole King in 1971. She wrote it as a response to James Taylor's hit song Fire and Rain, specifically in reference to the line in his song, "I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend." Famously, both Carole King and James Taylor recorded "You've Got a Friend" simultaneously at the same recording session. His version of the song became a number one hit, but don't feel bad for Carole King. She included it on her Tapestry album, which sold an incredible 25 million copies. Both James Taylor and Carole King won Grammy Awards for the song. He won for Best Male Pop Vocal Performance. She won for Song of the Year. Since then, the song has been recorded by everyone from Anne Murray to Michael Jackson. To perform it for you now, I'm very happy to introduce you to a young woman who has starred as Christine Daae in New York in an alternate musical version of The Phantom of the Opera, not to mention star performances at Feinstein's 54 Below and Frank Sinatra, The Second Century, and 54 Sings Broadway's Greatest Hits. Here is Jeanine Bruen.
When you're down and troubled and need some love and care, and nothing is going right, close your eyes and think of me, and soon I will be there to brighten up even your darkest night. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running. Oh yeah, see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you gotta do is call. I'll be there, yes I will. You got a friend. If the sky above you is dark and full of clouds, and that old north wind begins to blow, keep your head together, call my name. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running, oh yeah, to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you gotta do is call, and I'll be there, yes I will. Now ain't it good to know that you've got a friend, when people can be so cold? They'll hurt you, desert you, they'll take your soul if you let them, but don't you let them. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running, ooh, to see you. Don't you know that, baby, winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you gotta do is call, and I'll be there, yeah, yeah, yeah. You got a friend, you got a friend, ain't it good to know you got a friend? Mm-hmm. You got a friend, yeah, you got a friend.
Oh, Jeanine, you really beat me in the hat department. I would take my hat off to her, but I've got hat hair, so I'm not going to do it. So she was terrific. Now, moving on, though. This is a real special treat, and you'll soon see why. Let me begin by saying that Ragtime ranks among the best musicals of the 1990s. With a book by Terrence McNally and a score by Aaronson Flaherty, it was a serious and powerful work, both in its 1998 original production and its 2009 revival, and its message remains ever timely. I'm delighted to tell you that we have with us in this concert the star who played Cole House Walker Jr. in the original cast revival of the show in 2009. Since then, among his many triumphs, our starring roles on Broadway in the hit revival of Cats and the Tony Award-winning revival of Once on This Island. But it's particularly gratifying to have him come back to sing the song he performed 8 times a week on Broadway 11 years ago, with the performance that made him a star. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Quentin Earl Darrington.
Let it echo far and wide. Make them hear you. Make them hear you. How justice was our battle man. How justice was denied. Make them hear you. Make them hear you. And say to those who blame us for the way we chose to fight, sometimes there are battles that are more than black or white. And I could not put down my sword when justice was my right. Make them hear you. Go out and tell the story to your daughters and your sons. Make them hear you. Make them hear you. And tell them in our struggle we were not the only ones. Make them hear you. Make them hear you. Your sword may be a sermon or the power of the pen. Teach every child to raise his voice, and then, my brothers,
Then will justice be demanded by 10 million righteous men. Make them hear you. When they hear you, I'll be near you again.
Our next song ranks among one of the most popular romantic ballads of all time. Ironically, it was written for a show in 1938 titled Right This Way that was a total flop. The song from that show didn't become famous until the early 1940s, when in the midst of World War II, it became a huge popular success, and that popularity has never faltered. To sing it for you now, it's my great pleasure to introduce the Tony-nominated star of the Broadway production of Fun Home. She was just recently nominated for a Lortel Award for her starring role in the Transport Group revival of the unsinkable Molly Brown, and she also recently starred on Broadway in the revival of Angels in America. Here is the luminous Beth Malone.
I'll be seeing you in all the old familiar places that this heart of mine embraces all day through. In that small cafe, the park across the way, the children's carousel, the chestnut tree, the wishing well. I'll be seeing you in every lovely summer's day, in everything that's light and gay. I'll always think of you that way. I'll find you in the morning sun, and when the night is through, I'll be looking at the moon, but I'll be seeing you.
I have one more really fun song waiting for you at the other end of my brief thank you, so please hang in there for it. Now, my first thank you is to my technical director, Alexander Yakovlev, without whom, believe me, this presentation would not have been possible. He's the one who did all the technological heavy lifting to put this together, so thank you, Alexander. And here's my penultimate thank you. This special woman brings her intelligence, wit, and wisdom to these shows. I can't tell you how glad I am that she's my wife. She gives me emotional shelter while we shelter in place. Thank you, Barbara Siegel. Finally, a huge thank you to the people who gave money so that our performers could be paid. Performers are always the first people to volunteer to give their time and talent for a cause, performing in benefits whenever they're asked. Well, this time they shouldn't be asked to work for free. This time they should be paid because they're all out of work. They can't make a living now. But our producers came through to help. So on my behalf and on behalf of all the performers, thank you to all of the wonderful people who have given, and in so doing, have provided all of you with this concert. And this is your opportunity to join this growing list of audience producers that you'll see at the end of our show. There are actually four ways to do this, and any amount would be appreciated. There's the GoFundMe campaign, which you've been seeing on the screen occasionally throughout this concert. You can also give directly through either the Venmo or Zelle apps on your phone, if you have them. Or you can give the old-fashioned way with a check by emailing me at siegelentertainment@msn.com. I'll email you back with the information you'll need. Now, we'll put all of these methods up on the screen for you at the very end of our concert and hold them on the screen for you for a little while so you have time to write them down for reference. But I'll remind you also that this is not a streaming video. You can go back to see anything, including how to contribute, after this is over. But now, here is our final song. It was written by Irving Berlin, and it was first recorded by Danny Kaye in 1954, who also performed it in the classic 1954 movie White Christmas. And this gentleman has not only starred in the national tour of Irving Berlin's White Christmas, he has starred in everything from Anything Goes to 42nd Street. He was also in the film production of The Producers. To close our show, here is the ever-delightful Jeremy Benton.
The best things happen while you're dancing. Things that you would not do at home come naturally on the floor. For dancing soon becomes romancing when you hold a girl in your arms that you've never held before. Even guys with two left feet come out all right if the girl is sweet. If by chance their cheeks should meet while dancing, proving that the best things happen while you dance. Happen while you die.